Yes, you can start now.
Good evening to one and all. Greetings from Einstein College of Arts and Science Library. Now I request Professor Mr. M.S. Manikandan, Assistant Professor, Department of Business Administration, to deliver the welcome address and introduce our resource force. Mr. Manikandan, sir. It is audible.
Thank you. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. It's audible. And thank you, Dr. Mani, sir.
Proceed, sir.
Pleasant good evening to one and all gathered here. I'm happy to welcome everyone for this national level webinar on NDL user awareness, organized by Einstein College of Arts and Science, Tirunelveli, in association with National Digital Library of India under Ministry of HRD, Government of India, IIT Kharagpur. I take pleasure to welcome our honorable resource person of today's webinar, Professor Dr. Vignesh Swarnamohan, Chief Strategic and Out Research Officer, NDLI, IIT Kharagpur, West Bengal, a man of simplicity, eminent personality, a good speaker and a motivator. He has plenty of research experience and he has presented many papers, journals, articles, national and international level. He is a person and founder of brilliant IAS preparer, a mobile-based low-cost training solution for the civil service aspirant. Earlier to his to this, he worked with the Indian Public Library Movement and the CSC e-governance service India Limited. Vignesh has managed large development projects like National Digital Literacy Mission, Cybergram, Yojana, e-inclusion, IIT training for rural, SC/ST, women beneficiaries, e-vidya, and so forth. He has done lot of content relating to the development of the nation, as well as Professor Vigneshwar holds a Doctor of Philosophy from the Center of Study of Law and Governance, Jawaharlal Nehru University, New Delhi, with a Master in Public Management. He has been actively participating in various international forums. I welcome you, sir. Sir?
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Mr. M.S. Manikandan. Now I hand over the session to
Thank you, Dr. Manikandan and Dr. Mani for the kind introduction. So without wasting much time, let us get into the session. So is my audio clear and is my screen visible to all of you? If yes, kindly put it in the chat box. Okay, thank you. Thank you. So now we will get into the session. So today's session, we are going to look at six things. What are those six things? First and foremost, why NDLI? Why National Digital Library was established on the first hand? And then who is this for and what kind of content we have at NDLI? And how to access NDLI? And then what is the difference between Google and NDLI? And how to operate NDLI club in your own institution? So these are the six things that we are going to look at in today's session. So first, we will see why NDLI was set up. So on the screen, you can see an India map, which depicts the literacy rate of this country as per the 2011 census. So if you look at, except very few states like Kerala, Goa, Tripura and Mizoram, where the literacy level is above 90%, but in majority of the states, if you look at all these light color, light pink color shade, here the literacy level is below 75%, right? And this is one statistics. And on the other hand, we have another statistics which says every month at least 1 million people, that is 10 lakh people, are turning into 18 years of age every month. That means they are attaining an age of getting into the higher educational institution. So if India has to address the emerging requirement of education of these 1 million people, India needs to set up at least 6 universities and 270 colleges every month, at least for the next 20 months. But this is not applicable to states like Tamil Nadu or Karnataka or Andhra Pradesh, where there are plenty of educational institutions that have come up, but in rest of the states where there is a huge requirement and which are still unmet. So the government of India looked at the situation and they wanted to address this issue. So what they did was they looked at setting up, they are also setting up various physical colleges. However, the sustenance of these institutions, so once the colleges or universities are set up, that is one-time cost, but the maintenance and the operational expenses of these institutions are the most difficult part. So my humble request to all the participants, kindly stop sharing your screen so that it doesn't create any problem for others. So my humble request to each one of the participants, and don't unmute your mic during the session. And if anybody does it twice, then we might have to take them out from the webinar, because I don't want anybody others to suffer because of one or two persons. So kindly please follow the basic rules of this webinar. Right. So the government of India looked at various alternate solutions which can reach up, address this educational requirement. So they looked at digital solutions like Swayam, Swayam Prabha, NPTEL, Gyan, NDLA. All these are supplementary and complementary learning resource materials that were set up, say, in around 2014 to 16. That is the time period when these things were set up. Now, the second aspect of NDLA is, in the last 5 to 7 years, the budget and the human resource for managing the libraries have been drastically reduced. The reason was, so the moment the admission is less, or the moment some budget cut has been happening in the institution, the first budget that is cut in majority of the institution is the library budget. And so what does that imply? The moment the financial resources and the human resources are cut, it means you are going to procure a less number of quality resources. And once the less number of quality resources are books or articles or e-resources are not procured, then it is not giving access to the faculty members and the students. When they are given less access to the quality knowledge resources, then it means the learning outcomes of that institution or that entire institution is going to hamper. So many people don't really understand the importance of investing in the libraries. Except very few libraries where the library is located in the central part of the institution, wherein all the other departments revolve around the libraries. Majority of the institutions, the situation is completely different. And then there is next challenge of lack of additional physical infrastructure. Say, for example, the majority of the libraries were set up, say, 5-10 years before, and these institutions don't have adequate, they have not planned for a huge amount of resources that can be accommodated in the library. I've seen many of the institutions where the libraries procured resources, but they don't have space to stack these resources. So these resources were lying on the corridors of the library. So that is another situation. And apart from this, in the physical libraries, we have challenges of accessing the same resources by multiple persons at the same time. Suppose if there is a very good book and if a faculty prescribes it, in most likely situation, it might have been issued to another faculty member. and it may not be available for students or other faculty members to use these resources. So that is another challenge. And the next challenge is books being missing, hidden, and damaged. So we have seen in the libraries, like some brilliant student or some brilliant faculty member or even the library staff themselves, they hide the some of the resources in some corner of the library so that they don't get accessed. So that is also happening in the physical libraries. So the government of India looked at all these situation and they thought they should give access to quality knowledge resources to every Indian citizen. So they decided that they wanted to democratize education with quality access to knowledge resources. So that is when they realized the importance of NDLI, and they started NDLI way back in 2015, and in 2016 it was launched. In 2015 it was launched as a pilot project, and in 2018 it was dedicated to the nation on 19 June 2018 by the then MHRD Minister Sri Prakash Javadekarji. Now let us look at what do we have at NDLI. So the heart of NDLI is the metadata. At NDLI, we primarily ingest or store only the metadata. We don't store any full text content. And for people who are not from the library science background, metadata is nothing but data about data in definition terms. But in this context, metadata is nothing but the basic information about a resource. Say, for example, if there is a book, the title of the book, the author, the publisher, the number of pages, the abstract of the book, about the author. So the basic information about the book is called as metadata. So we only store metadata, right? Then you may ask me, then how will you give access to the full text resources? Now I will show you this next diagram. So imagine, so I'm just waiting for the screen to come. So how NDLI operates is we primarily work through content partners, right? So imagine this center, the server icon, this is NDLI, National Digital Library of India platform. So at NDLI, what we primarily do is we work with content contributors. So for example, if there is say Mananuniyam Sundaranar University, if they come and tell us they have 1,000 non-copyrighted open source resource materials which they wanted to digitize resources, which they wanted to share it with the entire nation. In that case, what we do with them is we tell them to create a institutional digital repository, that is IDR. So there are a couple of people. Mr. Unnamalai, kindly turn off your camera. So what we do is we just give me a moment. So kindly mute your mic. We help them. So I'm going to remove a couple of people who are keep on turning on their mic. I'm really sorry about it, but we have to do this. I'm sorry about it. So say for example, if Mananmayam Sundararayanu University, they have 1,000 non-copyrighted open source digitized resources, then we help them in setting up an IDR that is called Institutional Digital Repository, right? And then they create a metadata for those seven resources. So they create metadata for these 1,000 resources, and then we pull only the metadata from Mananmayam Sundararayanu University, and we store it in our database, right? Now, suppose if a researcher from say Delhi wants to access this resource which was published by Mananmayam Sundararayanu University, he comes to NDLI and he searches in our platform about this specific topic. And if this resource is coming from Mananmayam Sundararayanu University, then we, in that case, we redirect him to the Mananmayam Sundararayanu University's IDR. So IDR of Mananmayam Sundararayanu University, they verify the credentials of this user from Delhi, and then they give directly access to the entire resource to the researcher from Delhi directly. So in that process, what happens is we don't store any full text resources. So this is done for a specific purpose. I will talk about it in a little while. So as I mentioned, there are we primarily work with content contributors, and there are at least some 308 such content contributors spread across both India as well as international. You can see some of the content contributors whom we are working with. And then now let us see what type of content we have at NDLI. So we have computer science, information and general works content of around 1 crore, philosophy and psychology of about 5.4 lakhs, religion is about 2 lakh, social sciences are about 45 lakh resources, language is about 1 lakh, natural sciences and mathematics is about 85 lakh resources. Technology is another 1 crore resources. The arts, fine and decorative arts is about another 4.5 lakh resources. Literature and rhetoric is about 7.9 lakh resources. History and geography is about 6.1 lakh resources. So if you add these, you will see at least 4.8 plus crore resources available at NDLI. And what are these 4.8 crore content resources that are available at NDLI? So these 4.8 crore resources like a wide variety of content. Say it could be a faculty publication, thesis, dissertation, master's project, undergraduation projects, research material, research papers, PowerPoint presentations, video lectures, audio lectures, class notes, courseware, term papers, assignments, assessments, lab experiments, question bank, question papers, GSAT papers, annual reports, project reports, open access journals, ebooks, data sets, manuscripts, you name any form of reading and knowledge related material that is available at NDLI. And kindly listen to the presentation carefully, because at the end we have a quiz come feedback form, and all the questions are from this presentation only. So you have to carefully listen to this presentation. And these 4.8 crore content is divided into five different access options. And what are those five different access options? They are open resources, NDL users related resources, limited access, subscribed, and restricted access. So these are the five different types of access options that are available at NDLI. And then, so open and NDL users, these two logo, if you see them, it means it gives full text resources. The open and NDL users, these two icon, if you see in the text, it means you can get full text resources from this, these two resources. Limited means, say for example, if there are a 30 page article, out of which only 15 page may be available for you to view. Remaining page may not be visible for you. And subscribed is, say for example, IEEE or Springer. Suppose if your institution has subscribed to this resources, then you will be able to access them. Otherwise, you may not be able to access these resources. Restricted is, it's only for their internal consumption, not for any external use. Right. So you can identify this access option below every search results. Say for example, here you can see on the top this icon, green color open icon. This means it's a open access. So the first icon denotes the access option, and the second is the language, and the third one is content type. So these are the three icons that you can see below every search result. Now let us see the article, the resource type based content. So article dominates the list with almost say 3 crore results are about articles, right? Followed by books, which are 64 lakh resources. Reports are about 12 lakhs. Notes are about 11 lakhs. Law acts are about 8.7 lakhs. Law judgments are about 8.7 lakhs. Thesis is about 6.5 lakhs. Video lectures are about 3.78 lakhs. Now let us look at access option wise content. So I hope you remember, I told you there are 5 different access options that are available. Out of which open and NDL users, the green colored resources, are giving access to full text resources, right? So open resources are 2.79 crore resources, and NDLA users are about 77 lakh results. So if you add these two, 3.5 crore resources are full text resources. They are free to use. You can use it for educational and research purposes without having to pay a single penny to anyone, right? That is 73% of our resources are full text resources. Now let us look at who is this NDLI was designed for. So I told you there are 4.8 crore resources, and these resources are available for every age group, starting from the school going children. We have resources. We have resources for college going youths. We have resources for working professionals. We have resources for researchers and academicians. We have resources for entrepreneurs. We have resources for lifelong learners. So we have resources for anyone who is interested in learning and reading, right? Now I'm going to show you how to access NDLI. Accessing NDLI is very simple. What you need to do is go to Google and then type National Digital Library of India. So Dr. Mani, kindly put it in the chat box. For people, I think there are some people who are not able to listen to the audio. So what you need to do is put it in the chat box, how to turn on the audio in their system. Kindly put it in the chat box. So go to Google and then search for National Digital Library of India, and the first URL you get, the ldl.iitkgp.ac.in, that is the URL of NDLI, and also we have another URL that is called ndl.gov.in. Both the URLs work. So while opening this, what you need to do is just go and click here. Once you click on this, it will take you to our homepage. This is how our homepage of NDLI looks like. Okay. So here at the center, you can see the search box. So this is called the search box. And what you need to do is enter the search keyword here. So here I have put Tamil literature as a search keyword, right? And on the top, you can see a browse icon, and also we have a search icon here, and we have language tab. So actually using this, you can change the entire interface into your own mother tongue also. Currently, you can change it in 10 Indian languages. And also, you can see this section. So this is a newly designed section. So you can see this study at home, wherein we have our team has classified the resources into various educational level and domain. School, CBSE examination preparatory, engineering, science, humanities, literature, law, and management. And also we have our team has collated a COVID-19 research repository. And we also have some featured collections. So now we will see how to use search in NDLN. So you type the keyword and then click search. So this search button, you just have to click. Once you click, this will come. So now what I have done is I have changed the language into Tamil. So here you can see this language tab. So here I'm going to talk in Tamil. So inga vandu Tamil moli appdin irukum anga poi neenga adu click panni Tamil maathikalam. So suppose आप हिंदी में आप ये पूरा इंटरफेस देखना चाहते हैं तो वहाँ पे ऊपर भाषा आएगा, वहाँ पे वो दबा के हिंदी चूज करेंगे, फिर आपको पूरा इंटरफेस हिंदी में आ जाएगा. सो करेंटली आई हैव चेंज्ड दिस इनटू तमिल, सो यू कैन सी दिस एंटायर इंटरफेस इन तमिल, राइट. नाउ आई सर्च फॉर अ टॉपिक कॉल्ड तमिल लिटरेचर एंड देन आई क्लिक्ड सर्च, आई गॉट. Then I applied one filter called language. I wanted the resources only in Tamil. So I got 2,326 results on this topic of Tamil literature in Tamil language. Similarly, if you want to search, say for example, Hindi literature, you enter the search keyword as Hindi literature and then go to language. Language mein jaake wahan pe aap Hindi mein choose karenge, Hindi choose karenge, fir aapko pura Hindi language mein kitne bhi resources hain, wo sab cheez aa jayenge. Right? So now let's move on to the next topic. Then I searched for a topic called history of English literature. So I got 6.74 lakh resources on this topic of history of English literature. Here I applied one filter. I wanted the results only from the subject category of language and literature. I got 6.74 lakh resources on this topic of history of English literature. And the next topic I searched was on financial accounting. So I searched for a topic called financial accounting and I wanted only video lectures, right? So here you can see on the right hand side, you can see a tab called content type. So I clicked on video. So I got 1727 video lectures on this topic of financial accounting alone, right? So and the next topic I searched was on artificial intelligence. So here also I applied two filters. Subject category I wanted from computer science and technology and source from MIT OpenCourseWare. So I got at least 64 results on this topic of artificial intelligence alone. And then I searched for a topic called Java programming. Again, I wanted only video lectures on this Java programming. So I clicked on video. I got 3,197 results on this topic of video Java programming. So for using NDLI, what you need to remember is the various, first thing you need to know is the right search keyword. Okay. You should know which search keyword, correct search keyword without any spelling mistake. That is one. And the second one you need to remember is apply the relevant filters. So there are filter options which are available on the left hand side and also on the right hand side. So I'm going to talk about in detail about the various filter options in a little while. So on the left hand side, you can see the various filter options that are available for you. And the next topic I searched was on biochemistry, right? And here I wanted to know the various theses available on this topic of biochemistry. So what I did was I searched for this topic called biochemistry and then I wanted it from the source of InfluBNet Shodh Ganga. Okay, I think the screen has not yet changed for you. Please give. Yes. So here you can see I have searched for biochemistry and I applied for a filter called source. I wanted resources only from InfluBNet Shodganga. InfluBNet Shodganga holds the thesis of this country, the various theses that were submitted to various universities. It's a repository of all the theses that are available in this country. So what I did was I wanted this thesis available on biochemistry. I clicked on InfluBNet Shodganga. I got 3,383 results on this topic of biochemistry alone. Similarly, suppose if you want to pursue your MPhil or PhD, suppose if you want to do your like literature survey, so you want to do a search survey on, say, artificial intelligence. So you search for artificial intelligence and then go to source and then search for InfluBNet Shodganga. Then you will be able to know what are the theses that are already available on this topic of artificial intelligence. Similarly, if whatever is your thesis, you can search for it. So now we are going to look at, so I showed you at the beginning on the home page, you can see study at home, this section. Right. So we're going to see what is this study at home section available here. So study at home, and here you can see school. So this, if you click, suppose if you or your known family members or students are studying in schools. So if you click on schools, it will display you various school related contents. And then when you click on CBSE examination preparatory, it will show you the class 10 and class 12 CBSE preparatory material. And then engineering, it will show you various engineering disciplines and the related content for engineering. Science, it will display various science related content. Humanities, it will display various humanities content. Literature, law and management. So now I'm going to show you what are the type of content that are available in engineering and humanities. So let us see. So I clicked on humanities. So humanities, you can see general, history, geography, sociology, economics, psychology, political science, education, constitution and law, philosophy, mass communication, library science, music, film studies, right? So suppose if you want to know content from history, you just have to click on history. Similarly, if you want content from geography, just click on geography. So, and then I also searched for something called algebra and calculus. I wanted the results only from Khan Academy. I got 10,208 results on this topic of algebra and calculus. And then I searched for engineering. I clicked on engineering related content. So once you click on engineering from the home page, you will be able to see the various engineering disciplines related content. So for the first year, you will see some of the common subjects. You will see aerospace engineering related content, architecture, chemical engineering, civil engineering, computer science and engineering, electrical engineering, electronics and communication engineering, mechanical engineering, mining engineering. So suppose if you want content related civil engineering, just go here and click civil engineering, then you will be able to see content related to civil engineering. So now we are going to see how to download a resource from NDLI. Right. So here I searched for a topic called research methodology. Okay. And I wanted the results only from Lovely Professional University. So I got 1,438 results on this topic of research methodology. Now, suppose if you want to open this first topic, the first result, and what you need to do is just click on this research methodology. Once you click on that topic of interest to you, it will take you to a page. So this is how the page looks like, right? So on the top you can see two tabs, content content and metadata. First you need to click on metadata. Okay, once you click on metadata, you will be able to see the basic information. So this is called metadata, right? So here the title is research methodology, source coming from Lovely Professional University, content type is text, publisher is Excel Books Private Limited, file format is PDF, language is English, subject domain is social science, commerce, communication and transportation, commerce. So this is the metadata. Suppose if you find this information, if you see that this resource may be useful for you, then the second thing you need to notice is this access restriction. So since it's an open resource, it means you can download the entire book and use it for educational purpose, right? And the third thing you need to notice is whether you have logged into the system or not. Here you can see I've already logged into the system, so I can now download. So for downloading, what you need to do is just go here and click on content. So once you click on the content, it will download the entire resource into your desktop or laptop or mobile phone, whichever device you are using. So this is how the entire book, 338 page of content, has been downloaded into your system. Imagine, suppose you have not logged in. So here on the top you can see I have not logged in. In that case, if you clicked on content, it will take you to this page. It will ask you to log in to view this content. So you have to click on this login. Once you click on this login, this pop-up window will appear. Okay, it will ask you to enter your email ID and password, registered email ID and password. Okay, suppose if you are already you remember your email ID and registered email ID and registered password, just enter these details. Enter the captcha and then click on login. Then you will be able to download the content. Imagine you registered at NDLI 6 months or 1 year back and you forgot your password. In that case, what you can do is you click on this account recovery. Okay, once you click on this account recovery, it will ask you to enter the registered email ID. You enter your registered email ID and then click submit. Once you submit, you will get a verification password reset email. You just have to follow the process and then reset your password and then come back and enter your email ID and password. Then now you can download this resource. Suppose if you have heard about NDLI, but you've never registered for NDLI, you have never used it. In that case, what you can do is you can freshly register yourself. So what you need to do is just click on register. So there is a form that will pop up like this. Just enter the basic details and then submit. Once you submit, you will get a verification email. Just follow the process and then complete it. Okay. Suppose if it's a video lecture, this is of the video lecture will load. Okay. So like I said, for using NDLI, you need to remember two things. One is you need to know the right search keyword. And the second one is know the various filter options that are available to narrow down the results. So now I'm going to talk about some 8 important filter options. Right. The first filter option is access restriction. Suppose if you want only full text resources, then go here and then click open. Open and NDLI. Once you click on open and NDLI, then you will get only the full text resources. And the second important filter option is author. You can choose the relevant author. Say for example you search for a topic and you want the results only from Voizang, just go here and choose the relevant author. You will get results from the author. And the next one is subject category. Depending on the search keyword, you can choose the subject category and then narrow down the results. And the fourth filter option is file format. Suppose if you want only PDF files, go here and choose only PDF, then you will get PDF files. And the fifth filter option is language. Right. So at NDLI, the resources are about available in 300 languages, both Indian as well as international languages. Right. So you can choose the language of your choice. Suppose if you want content only in Tamil, or if you want content only in Hindi or Marathi or in Kannada or in Malayalam. So you have to choose the language of your choice and then narrow down the results. And the sixth filter option is learning resource type. At the NDLI, there are at least some 60 different types of learning resource types that are available. So you have to choose the relevant learning resource type and then narrow down the results. And the seventh filter option is source. So I told you there are 308 content partners. So all the sources, 308 content partners are coming under this source. Suppose if you want content only from Bangalore University, just go here and choose Bangalore University, you'll get the content from Bangalore University. Similarly, Bloomsbury is there. So you can check the various filters, the various content partners that are available at NDLI. And the eighth important filter option, which is available only in the desktop application. This filter is not available in the mobile app. So this is the content type filter. Okay. So I have already told you the NDLI interface can be changed into various Indian languages. So suppose if you want content in, we want to change the content into various languages, just go to the top, choose the, click on the language, you will see the drop down menu, various Indian languages, you choose the language of your choice and that interface will change into your language of choice. Currently it's available in Hindi, Bangla, Gujarati, Marathi, Kannada, Uriya, Tamil, Malayalam and Assamese, right? And you can change it into these languages, and more Indian languages are also being added in the system. Now, for the ease of use, especially for the young generation, our team has developed a mobile app, NDLI mobile app, both in Android as well as in iOS. Right? Suppose if you are using an Android phone, go to Play Store and then search for National Digital Library of India. Enter the entire word. Don't put NDLI, then you may not get the desired result. You have to enter the entire name, then you will be able to see this logo, name and the publisher name. All the three should be National Digital Library of India. Then you can click on install, then this app will get installed in your mobile phone. Similarly, if you are using an iPhone, go to a store and then search for the entire name, National Digital Library of India, and then you can install the app in your iPhone as well. So once you install the app, just click on the app. So once you click on this app, this is the first screen, is the home page of home screen of NDLI Android mobile app. So now we are going to see how to use NDLI Android mobile phone. Right. So suppose if you want to search, what you need to do is on the second screen, you can see this search icon on the top. Right. So just click on this, then this search box will appear. Here you have to enter the search keyword. Right. And then click search from the keypad, then I search for Uttar Pradesh. I got 41,573 results on this topic of Uttar Pradesh. Now, if you want to narrow down the results, so you should use filters. In the desktop application, you had the filter option on the left hand side and on the right hand side. But whereas in the mobile app, this filter option is available on the right bottom corner. This orange color icon, this is the filter option in the mobile app. Just click this, then you can see on the third screen the various filter options that are available. We saw 10 filter options. All the 10 filter options will be displayed on the top. Okay, so you can scroll down this section to see the various filter options. So here I applied for a filter called source. And I wanted the results only from Aligarh Muslim University. So I clicked on Aligarh Muslim University and then I clicked on apply. I got 199 results. Okay. So I'm just waiting for the screen to come. Here you go. So here you can see I clicked on source. I chose Aligarh Muslim University and then I applied. I got 199 results. So this is how you need to use the NDLI mobile app. So now I'm going to give you an activity. Okay. So it's a 5-minute activity. What you need to do is, I want, I want each one of you to download the NDLI mobile app. I want you to download the NDLI mobile app from the Play Store or the store, iPhone. If you are using iStore, go to iPhone, go to iStore, and then download NDLI mobile app, install it, and then search for the topic of your subject of study or your subject of teaching or subject of your interest. And then you put it in the chat window, whether you installed the app, which topic you searched, and how many results you found.
Okay. Yeah.
So now it's 6:48 in my system. I'm going to give you 5 minutes. Miss Pintu Chakrabarti, kindly mute your mic and don't turn on your camera. Otherwise, I may have to remove you from the webinar. Please, kindly don't do this. Okay. And so your 5 minute time starts now. Your 5 minute time starts now. What you need to do is install the NDLI mobile app and then search for the topic of your subject of study or subject of teaching or subject of interest, and then tell us in the chat box how many results you found. Yes, now the screen is not visible. Subita, kindly turn off your camera. I don't want anybody to turn on their camera, please. It's for your security reason. Kindly don't turn on your screen, turn on your camera. So no screen will be visible. I want each one of you to kindly install the app and search for the topic of your interest. Okay. And your time has already started. So Tamil ellarku oru nokku solliduren, NDLI mobile app poi Android phone use panninga Play Store ponga, iPhone use pandringana I Store la poi National Digital Library of India oda mobile app install panni ungaloda subject of study neenga enna padikiringalo adula enna topic ungalku kashtama irukko adha neenga search panni paarenga adha vandu ella enna topic la search panninga evlo results ungalku kadinjirchu nu solli chat window la potu udunga. हिंदी में कितने भी अभी मैंने एक्टिविटी दिया उसका आप एन डी एल ए मोबाइल ऐप को इंस्टॉल कीजिएगा अपना मोबाइल फ़ोन पे, फिर सर्च करके कोई भी टॉपिक हो आपके मन की पसंद हो सकता है, आप कोई भी सब्जेक्ट पढ़ाते हैं नहीं तो पढ़ते हैं, आप उसको सर्च करके फिर आप चैट विंडो में डाल दीजिएगा आप कौन सा टॉपिक सर्च किया और कितने रिजल्ट मिले हैं. ठीक है, आपके पास 5 मिनट है, अब समय ऑलरेडी शुरू हो चुका है, जल्दी कीजिएगा. We have 3 more minutes. I could see Prasanna PK downloaded entrepreneurship 37,700. Very good, Prasanna. R. Deepika, library science. She found 71 lakh. Mr. Ramachandran, entrepreneurship. Very good. Mukesh Kumar, Patna University. Very good, Mukesh Kumar ji. Research methodology in education. Prince, copyright, ADFF. B. Meenachi. Pushpa Kashi, Dr. P. Kirtika's research methodology, very good. Dr. X. Anita Arul, 411 diasporic literature, very good. Dr. Anita, pharmacy was very nice topic. Okay, Praveen Manu, psychology, Vilma, very good. So keep searching and then put it in the chat box. Kindly mute your mic, Kausalya, please. I have logged the meeting, so no new participant can come in. And if you move out of the webinar, you will not be able to rejoin again. And we will share the feedback form, quiz cum feedback form, at the end of the webinar. And you are requested to be patient and kindly attend it properly. one more minute to go. Okay, social history, racism in literature, digital library, agricultural economics, educational research, Victorian era literature, cost accounting books. Okay, what is mean of NDLI user? Very good question, Mr. Prince Kumar Gupta. NDLI user is nothing but, this is specifically the government of India has procured national licensing. I will talk about the national licensing in a little while. I will tell you that time. NDLI user is specifically for these resources are only for registered users of NDLI. Marathi literature, Swarnaji searched, Parameshwari searched on educational research, Ponchitra searched on physics. Okay, the arts, fine and decorative arts, G. Magalakshmi, business administration, V. Meenakshi, Shivakumar articles. Okay, very good. Mechanics, Mr. Suresh searched on mechanics. Indian Constitution, Parameshwari E. So he says she got 10,000 results. Very good. So now, if you see this resource useful, this app and the resources useful for you, and if you think this could be useful for people like you, my humble request to you is kindly share it with at least 100 people. That's the humble request that I have. So that's a biggest service that you can do to this nation. Spread the knowledge that you have so that more people can get benefited out of it, right? So that's the humble request I have. Now we will get into the presentation. Is my audio and the presentation waiting for this presentation to come? Yes. So is my audio and the presentation visible to you? Yes. So now we will see what is the difference between Google and NDLI. So we will see it with the help of an example. Right? Imagine there is a girl called Payal who is studying in class 8 and her mother tongue is Hindi. She wants to know about magnetism in the subject of physics. Okay? And similarly, there is a guy called Shamik. Okay. Similarly, there is a guy called Shamik who wants to pursue his PhD on the topic of magnetism. So now both of them have gone to Google and then they searched for the same topic called magnetism and both of them got same results. They got 1.89 crore results. Now, and then they came to NDLI. They came to NDLI desktop application or mobile application, whichever they feel comfortable. And they searched for the same topic, magnetism. And they got 11,16,000 results. Now, what Payal did was, she applied two filters. She chose in the educational level, 5th to 8th standard. And then she chose the language as Hindi. And she got only 8 results. And then what Shamik did was he chose only career and technical papers. He went to the educational level and then he chose only career and technical paper. He got 219 results. So imagine where is 1.89 crore results and where is 8 and 219 results. So now let us see what is the difference between Google and NDLI with the from this example. So Google is a brilliant tool. It does its job brilliantly. Right, we don't have any competition with Google. Google is a brilliant giant, right? Now, So what Google does is, the moment you put the term called magnetism, it goes around the World Wide Web, and wherever this term called magnetism is there, it fetches the results. And in this process, what Google can't do is, it can't distinguish whether this is coming from an authentic source or an unauthentic source, whether it is a real information or a fake information, whether it is educational content or non-educational content, whether it is relevant for Shamik or Payal. It can't distinguish. It treats everyone as equals, and it gives the same results to everyone. Whereas at NDLA, all our content partners, as I told you, we primarily work through content partners. All our 388 content contributors are only working in educational domain. They are either educational institutions or research institutions or publishing industries, right? And they are all curated educational content only. And then at NDLA, you can narrow down the filters, content using filters specifically designed for educational purposes. But whereas in Google also, you can do narrow downing of results using the advanced search option, but that is very generic in nature. And the third difference is, you can modify the search based on the content type. And then the fourth difference is national licensing. So here, I want to respond to the question of, what does that NDLA user mean? The NDLA user means, suppose when the government is procuring national licensing and giving it to the registered users of NDLA. So these resources come under the NDLA users. So only for people who are registered at the NDLA, they will be able to access national licensed content. Right? So that is the meaning. Now let us look at how to operate NDLA club in your own institution. So before we see this, I wanted to tell you, there are two, there is a twin objective of starting an NDLA club in your educational institution. What are those twin objectives? The first objective is, create the culture of reading. So in majority of the situation we have already come across, the culture of reading has been declining. Maybe it is taking a different shape. So that is what people say. But in general, there is a feeling that the culture of reading is declining. See, the government of India wanted to bring back the culture of reading. So that is one of the objectives. And the second one is, take the knowledge resources of NDLA to every Indian citizen. So these are the twin objectives of NDLA club. And to start this NDLA club, what you need to do is, first to form a club members. So who are these members? Identify at least one student from each class and one faculty member from each department. And the ex officio secretary could be a librarian or a faculty member or an NSS coordinator. The important criteria is, they should be very dynamic and they should do something to promote the culture of reading. And the ex officio chairman is the principal or a head of the institution. So you form the club and then get the list approved by the head of the institution. And then you have to apply for the NDLA club registration. So there is a club registration form that is available. So the once you click on, so we send a URL, club registration form URL. So once you click this temporary NDLA club registration form will be shown. I will just waiting for the screen to come. Okay, so in the club registration form, what you need to do is enter the basic information of your institution, like name of the institution, which state, district, address, and how many students are there, the basic information about the institution, and then attach the list of the NDLA club members, and when are you planning to start the institution club, and then click on submit. Once you click on submit, this application will come to us. So we will do a backend verification of your institution. And if it matches with our record, then we issue a certificate of registration for NDLA club. That certificate of registration is valid for 1 year. Okay. Within that 1 year, what you need to do is, you need to do two steps. The first step is, you need to register all your students and faculty members within 30 days of receipt of the certificate. This is the most important step. Okay. And the second step you need to do is, conduct at least 10 reading or knowledge related activities. So now we will see how to do the registration part. So For registration, there are two mechanisms. For registration, there are two mechanisms. Is my audio and video clear? There is somebody saying it's not clear. Okay.
So now it's okay.
Okay, thank you. So for registration, there are two options. Yeah, you can either do an individual registration or do a bulk registration. So individuals can go to the NDLA website and then they can click on the login button and they can register. For higher educational institution, especially if you go for bulk registration, what you can do is when UGC, NAC, AICT, or NBA comes for accreditation or renewal, that time they will ask you to submit if what learning resources you have subscribed to. Suppose if you tell them you've registered for NDLI, then they will ask you to show the statistics of how many students registered, how many students activated. Suppose if your college students and the faculty members registered as individual participants, then they may not be able to show their statistics. So in that case, if you do bulk registration, then you will be able to show them how many participants have registered. Okay. So now I'm going to show you how to do bulk registration. So for doing bulk registration, what you need to do is create an awareness about NDLI to all your students and faculty members. Okay. And then collect three details from them: their email ID, preferably the personal email ID, their first name and last name. You can see on the top this Excel sheet. So you have to enter these three details of each students and faculty members. And then save it as an Excel file and then send it to us. So you have to send it to this email ID of ndl-support@iitkgp.ac.in with a copy to my email ID, which is vignesh@ndl.gov.in or vigneshjnu@gmail.com. You send it to our email ID. And once you send it to us, within 48 hours, we will send an automated registration email to each one of the email IDs you have given us. Okay. Then what you need to do is get the students and the faculty members to your library or to a computer center and make them register in front of you. Make them activate their account in front of you, because once you leave it to them, they will never do it because they are so busy, right? So kindly get this process done immediately after getting the confirmation from email from us, right? Suppose if we want to register as an individual, suppose if your family members or friends or relative want to register for NDLI, then they can do so. How they can do is go to the home page. On the top right corner, you can see this login button. So you click on this login button and this pop-up window will appear. So there is this register icon is there. Okay, just click on this register, then you will get this NDLI registration form. So it will capture your full name. So this is how the NDLI registration form will look like. You have to enter your full name, your email ID, password, confirm password, date of birth, gender, state, city, educational role, language, institute name, and enter the CAPTCHA, choose the terms and condition, and then click sign up. Once you do this, you will get a verification email, right? So sometimes it may go into your spam folder also. So kindly check it's not in the spam folder as well. So this is about the registration. Now let's come to the last part, which is conducting 10 reading or knowledge related activities. So what are these activities that you can conduct under NDLI club? So you can conduct a lecture series, you can conduct a quiz competition, you can conduct a storytelling session, you can conduct a go fish game, you can do a film screening, you can do a drawing competition, it could be a role play, writing competition, maker space, debate, and you can also come up with your own reading or knowledge related activity. And you can also do inter-college activities or competitions as well, right? For doing this, what you need to do is first get the faculty members' support for this initiative. Unless and until the students and the faculty members are actively involved, this club activity may not be relevant. And also, kindly see if you can do an assignment. Every month, at least one assignment could be done. And these are some of the activities being conducted by various NDLI clubs across the country. Okay, so this is what I wanted to tell you about NDLI. So if you have any specific questions, kindly put it in the chat window. And after the questions, we will share the feedback form URL with each one of you. Any questions? So there is a question of Dr. Y. Arcia Tarnam. She registered, but she didn't get confirmation email. So kindly check if it's in the spam folder. So this is how your feedback form will look like. It will ask for your full name. And then full name of your institution. Suppose if you are from Einstein College of Arts and Science, just choose here. Suppose if you are from other institution, click on other, then it will ask you to enter your institution name. Enter the full name of your institution. Okay, so before, I think there is a question. I had a doubt, in mobile app, there is no download option. So it is there at the bottom. Once you click on the relevant article, at the bottom you will see download option. So you, that is there in the mobile app, but you should best register. It will ask you to log in to view this content. So there is a question from Dagnam Riba. Sir, I have a question regarding the use of this application. Actually, I cannot avail the books from foreign author or writer. What to do in that case? So see, it's primarily open source resources. At the NDLA, we only encourage open source resources. And 73% of our resources are full text resources. Some cases you may get foreign authors, some cases you may not get, right? So, but I'm sure you will get the content to read. See, what do we need at least? At the end, what we need is get our concepts clear and get our ideas clear. For that, this is a good platform to learn. Yes, we will upload the our PPT in our website. In our project website, which we will send it to you tomorrow. Yes, you can have all NDLA have all book in soft copy in online. No, see, we may not have your subject textbooks. See, for example, if Mananuyam Sundaranar University, they give you, prescribe you some books to follow. We may not have that book, but suppose if it's a C programming or Java programming or artificial intelligence. Suppose if there are 10 topics that need to be addressed, if you put each of the topics, we will have content for you. It could be a video lecture or an audio lecture or a PowerPoint presentation. It would be definitely there. But we may not have the textbooks that are prescribed to you. Okay, so there is a question from Dr. Anita. Could you explain about club activities and if it is by an individual, what about assignments, sir? See, club activities has to be conducted by the entire club. It could be driven by both students and faculty members, right? And what about assignment? Assignment, suppose if you are a faculty member, right? Suppose if you are a psychology faculty member, every month you can give them an assignment. Say it could be a industrial psychology. And you can encourage the students to use the NDLA resources to submit an assignment. So like that, you can encourage the usage of NDLA. Yes, we will share the PPT with you. Feedback link we will send after the questions are over. Any other questions? Okay, there are not much question. From where I can find this PPT, sir, as you mentioned. Okay, don't worry, I will send it to you. Once the certificate is ready, we will send you the certificate along with this presentation as well. So now I'm going to enter the Solungama.
Hello. சார், இப்ப ஆர்கிடெக்சர் டிபார்ட்மெண்ட்ல ஃபாரின் ஆத்தர் புக்ஸ் கேக்குறாங்க அப்படின்னா, பட் நாங்க அதை சர்ச் பண்ணி அவங்களுக்கு கொடுக்கணும் அப்படின்னா புக்ஸா கிடைக்காது? ஏன்னா ரேர் புக், காஸ்ட்லி புக்ஸ் அது. அது வந்து நம்ம என்டிஎல் மூலமா அவங்களுக்கு வந்து இ புக்ஸ் டவுன்லோட் பண்ணி கொடுக்க ஆப்ஷன் இருக்கா?
நீங்க டாபிக் சர்ச் பண்ணி பாத்தீங்கன்னா கண்டிப்பா புக் இருக்கும். நீங்க என்ன பண்ணலாம்னா, நீங்க ஒரு டாபிக்கை சர்ச் பண்ணி பார்த்துட்டு அங்க போய் நீங்க ரிசோர்ஸ் லேர்னிங் ரிசோர்ஸ் டைப்ல போய் புக்குன்னு சூஸ் பண்ணிட்டீங்கன்னா அந்த டாபிக்ல இருக்க புக்கு வந்து கிடைச்சிடும். சி, அஸ் ஐ டோல்ட் யூ, தேர் ஆர் 64 லாக் ரிசோர்சஸ் அவேலபிள் அஸ் புக்ஸ். 3 க்ரோர் சார் அவேலபிள் அஸ் ஆர்டிகல்ஸ். எஸ் ப்ளீஸ்
சார். அவங்க எப்படி கேக்குறாங்கன்னா இமேஜ் ரிலேட்டடா கேக்குறாங்க சார். செட்டிநாடு ஹவுஸ் இருக்கு இல்லையா, காரைக்குடி செட்டிநாடு அந்த மாதிரி கேக்குறாங்க புக்ஸ்.
யூ சர்ச் அது வந்து வாட் ஐ வாண்ட் யூ டு டு இஸ் நீங்க என்ன பண்ணுங்கன்னா, நீங்க முதல்ல NDLA ல சர்ச் பண்ணி பாருங்க அந்த டாபிக்ல அந்த ரிசோர்சஸ் இமேஜஸ் இருக்கான்னு பாருங்க. இருந்துச்சுன்னா 99% ஐ அம் ஷூர் இட் மைட் பீ தேர். இட்ஸ் தேர் தென் யூ ஷேர் இட் வித் தேம்.
ஓகே
ஓகே ஓகே. Thank you, sir. I have entered the feedback form URL in the chat box, so kindly be very careful in filling the feedback form. Don't make any mistakes. If you make any mistake in your full name, your institution name and the email ID, then I cannot help you, because it's an automated systems generated certificate, and if you make any mistakes there, then I may not be able to help you. After that, don't come back to me and say that my name has to be corrected, that request may not be entertained. You have to be very careful while submitting the feedback form. Three details you have to be very careful. You have to enter your full name, your institution's full name, your email ID, phone number, and then there are some questions. You need to score at least some 50% mark in getting the certificate of participation, right? So kindly copy the feedback form URL and keep it with you handy, because we are going to end this webinar. Over from my end, over to Dr. Mani. Dr. Mani, yes, over to you.
Yes, sir. Yeah, yes, sir. Audible, sir? Hello.
Yes, kindly.
Hello.
Yes.
Sir, audible? Yeah, it is officially a vote of thanks. It's my duty, pleasure to deliver a vote of thanks. Thank you so much, sir, for accept our proposal and jointly with our college library organizing a wonderful effective webinar. Heartful thanks to our resource person, Dr. Vignesh Shornamogan, sir. Sir, I kindly request you to, sir, you are being with us in all endeavors to our growth of our college, sir. I take this junction to thank our management, Professor Amudavanan, sir, and our secretary, Professor Elilvanan, sir. And also I thank to our beloved principal, Dr. A. Murugesan, sir. Without our principal sir's support, I cannot do anything. Thank you so much, sir. Addition to that, I thank the pillar of our institution, head of the various departments and faculty members and ICAS family members. I special thanks to my student volunteers and friends. Also, I thank to, last but not least, I hope I thank special thanks to all the participants from in Tamil Nadu and outside Tamil Nadu. Thank you so much, one and all. We support you to the all the participants coming soon. Also, we say thank you so much, sir. Vignesh, sir.
So I have entered the feedback form URL again, so kindly fill the feedback form. It will be open only for next 15 minutes. We will close it maximum by 8 o'clock, so I'm giving you 45 minutes to fill this form, and be very careful in filling this form. So with this, we are going to end this webinar, and once again we thank the Institute College of Arts and Science and Dr. Mani for organizing this webinar, and the entire volunteer team of Einstein College of Arts and Science, and all the participants who have come from across the country. And once again, we thank each one of you for participating. And I'm sure this NDLA webinar is useful for you. And if it's useful, and if you find the app also useful, kindly share it with at least 100 people in next 30 minutes. That's my humble request. Once again, thank you. And we are going to end this webinar now.